Discord. Okay. I'm gonna count it down and then we'll go ahead and begin from there. So let's just pray real quick and then we'll do it. Holy Spirit, Lord, we just thank you so much for this. We thank you for this interview. We thank you for this conversation, Lord, that we're about to have. We just ask, Lord, that you would bless it, that you would be in the midst of it, Lord, as we just talk about you, we just talk about your presence, and we talk about what you did so we can share with people what you're doing in their lives. So we thank you, Father, for Sarah and Juan. Allow this conversation to flow with your spirit. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.
Amen.
Okay. So we're gonna
Amen.
go and start this, and I'm gonna do this for for my editor for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hey everybody, welcome back. I'm so excited because we have Sarah and her husband Juan, who are joining us today. As I said yesterday in the video, that we were gonna interview them further. So first of all, really thank you guys so much for joining me in this conversation and for waiting on me because I know I had you guys waiting for a couple of minutes.
Thank you for having us.
That's all right, Freddie.
Okay, so I really am interested in hearing, you know, we saw yesterday, even though it was recorded back in December, we saw yesterday your testimony where you talked about what God did in the encounter. The first thing that I really want to talk about is the vision that you experience in the visual. Could you go into detail, Sarah, about what you experienced and what you saw?
Yeah, so in that moment, I'm just gonna go ahead and start off by being honest and raw. Before the encounter, I was at a place spiritually that I felt like kind of in a wilderness, you know, to use an example.
Right.
It was hard for me to really like hear God's voice because everything else around me seemed louder. Things that I was personally dealing with, you know, family members and stuff like that. So, before going to the encounter, it was really hard for me to even focus on the things of God. So when I was there in that moment, it was at the time of the visual where I saw that vision. And I remember before starting in the visual, my mind and my heart, I was like, you know what? I'm just gonna surrender everything right now. I'm gonna forget about what's happening, what's not happening, and really get lost, right? Really get lost in God. And I was just preparing my heart really to experience Him in a new way. I really needed that. At that time, I really needed him to come through in a sense to kind of show me something because I've been hoping and for so long for certain things, personal things that really hadn't come to pass. And so at that time, I remember I was just worshiping God and it was beautiful. Everybody was in one accord. Everyone was just, you know, praising God in the way that they do it. So I felt so free to do whatever. I remember dancing, you know, being on the floor, just crying at times. I mean, I was lost. So in that time when I had the vision, I remember just seeing like fire, almost like if I was seeing it in person. You know, it's kind of hard to describe a vision because it's not really something that you can explain in the physical. But I just remember seeing like just fire coming up, you know, just like if you can see inside of a fire flame, if that makes any sense. But then I remembered after all that was done, you know, God is a consuming fire. That's what his word says. And
Right.
so I really think in my heart that God allowed me to see that fire because he was purifying whatever it is that was in my soul that was hindering, you know, me to receive, you know, what is mine, hearing his voice, his promises coming to pass. So I really feel like he showed me that fire to cleanse me in a way.
Wow. Wow. And how did your spiritual walk change or alter after the encounter?
Well, for me, I just feel like he is closer than what I think. You know, I feel that he is closer. I mean, he was always there, but it's us that kind of draw ourselves apart. You know, when we go through hard seasons in life and confusion and all this, you know, different stuff that the enemy tries to throw at us. And I just feel like closer to him now. I hear his voice clear. I'm having prophetic dreams.
Wow.
Yeah. After the encounter, I had like a week's worth of prophetic dreams. Obviously, when there's prophetic dreams, sometimes they're good and sometimes they're not so good. But he's the God that protects us. So even if it's bad prophetic dreams, it's still good because it's from him. Right. So I had a couple of warning dreams for family members.
I was gonna ask you actually, by any chance, did you receive any prophetic warnings for like America or the church, or was it more like personal family members?
It was more personal, and I took it up to the Lord whenever all of that was going on, because I was really like, it kind of hit me off guard in a way, because I haven't really experienced prophetic dreams that intense, that it happened the next day. So I took it up to prayer with God, and I remember the Holy Spirit was telling me,
you had dreams that happened the next day after.
That happened the next day. Yeah.
No way. Could you
yeah.
an example, if you can, or like you can be generous?
I'm just gonna give a little bit because it's kind of personal for family members. But my mom was involved in a car accident at 2 a.m. on I think it was December 30th. I had a dream that I saw a lady being wounded, and then I saw a boy in front of her being wounded. Well, as far as my mom, I seen that she would go in the hospital and she had a report, but she walked out with the report. So she got hit by a drunk driver. And she came out with no broken bones, no scratches. She did come out the hospital a couple hours after.
Wow.
Yeah. But thankfully she was okay. What was that?
How bad was the accident?
Her car was totaled, and she flipped to the passenger seat when it happened. It was terrible, but God protected her life. I remember thinking, I woke up that same night that I had the dream, and I said, Lord, I don't know what this dream means, because that's one area that I need to grow in dream interpretation and, you know, really discerning what that means. So I just remember giving it to God and saying, you know what, I don't know what this means, Lord, but whatever it is, I ask that you protect this person from whatever they may go through. And so, yeah, she came out, and a couple hours later, she came out of the hospital and she was fine.
You had no idea that when you had that dream of that person being wounded, you had no idea that that would be your mother.
That would be my mother. And then the boy in front of her also got wounded, like shot. It was a close family member of mine that was going through some really, really deep stuff that I can't really share, just for his own personal protection. And I was just like, that same morning I had the phone call from my mom and that family member that confirmed to me what that dream meant. And I was I was really shook, to say the least.
That's amazing. Do you feel like God gave you that dream so that you can pray against really what was to come and pray for protection?
I believe so. I believe he did, because like I said, after these dreams, I remember crying out to God and asking him, like, why did you give me those dreams? Like, not complaining, but I just wanted to know, like, what do I need to do so that, whatever it is that you're trying to tell me, I can, pray about or whatever. And the Lord told me, I need you to focus on what's around you first, and then I can grow you and the other stuff. So first he wants to train me up what's around me, what's going on around me, family members, with people in my world. So he wants me to really like pr pray for those things, and just focus on those minor things, the people around me, and then he'll give me the much more after. So that's why I feel he gave it to me, just to kind of train me up.
Wow, that's honestly really powerful, and I really believe that it's amazing how God works, that God would give you a dream, a prophetic dream of something bad happening, and even though we don't fully understand it, I really believe that He used the prayer that you gave with not much understanding of what you really are praying, but He used that prayer really to save your family. And God knows what would have happened, if you had not prayed. I really believe that God did use that to protect them. And it's amazing because, sometimes there are prophetic warnings that we receive that are just going to happen. Like, we can't necessarily stop them from happening, but the Lord will allow us to pray to protect any harm from coming to the person. And so I really believe that is really what happened with your family. So that's awesome. That's
Yeah,
really,
it's new.
amazing. Well, that's definitely God. Well, tell me, let's talk about Juan. Who's your husband? Juan was not supposed to be.
Yeah, he was not supposed to be there. He was actually supposed to be babysitting because we have a 6-year-old, and I was supposed to be volunteering. And he was like, okay, well, I'll just go to the aquarium and do all this stuff with him. And no, God dragged him in it.
So how did that happen? And Juan, you just go ahead and tell it from your side.
What part, man? How did what? Like, what part of it?
Let's talk about, well, you came in, you were supposed to babysitting, but you ended up just being part of the event. And what was it that impacted you? Like, what was the moment where you felt like God began to touch you?
Really, man, honestly, it was none of the nights, to be honest. Like, I'm gonna be straight up, this is real. I'm being real with you. Like, and everybody I tell this story to, it doesn't change, because the moment that really was very impactful, and what I was really waiting for, was when you were talking about how, you were gonna have that prophetic presbytery and the one-on-one with everybody. And I was like, oh, okay, well, let's see, let's see.
I'm gonna pause him for a second. A month before, I have to share this. A month before the event, we had a conversation in our living room on a Sunday evening. I remember, because we were both like kind of laughing at this after the event. I talked about prophets. For some reason, the conversation about prophets came up, and I was like, yeah, prophets are still existing. They're still, prophesying to people. And he was like, well, I never met one, so I don't know. And so he was very like, skeptical in a way. Like, I never
So
met a prophet, so I don't know if it's real.
that you didn't believe in prophets or prophecy?
You see, that's the thing, man. you know, because, well, like, because I had talked to Danville that day, like, I think it was Saturday before I left to take my son swimming. While we were there, is like, I gave Danville a little, you know, piece of what I was going through at the time. And I was like, but I had told her my experience about prophets is, you know, like, you know, people call themselves prophets and they want to say this and they want to say that. I said, majority of prophets, what they want to do is predict the future. And, you know, I said, and so many people now have the misrepresentation of what a prophet really is. Like, you tell me prophet, I'm thinking you're fixing to fortune tell me something, you know, because that's what majority of people think. Like, hey, these people are gonna. And then when actual, you know, all these ministers that a lot of people see on TV, they prophesy, oh, the end of the world, the president this and that, and it doesn't happen. Well, guess what? The belief in prophets just goes down and down, and that's a true fact. Absolutely. So for me, it was like, you know, being to a couple of churches and hearing a lot of people call themselves prophets. And then you are sitting there in the seats like, well, hopefully he chooses me. Hopefully he says something about me, because, you know, if he is a prophet, then he should know what's going on in every single person. And that was my mentality, like, about prophets, you know. And then, like, Danville had given me like a little different side, and I was like, okay, man. He's like, yeah, just give us a shot, man, and you know, we'll turn that around. And I was like, all right. He's like, just come back. I said, yeah, I'll be back, man. And I went back, and I mean, for me, that was the thing that I was more interested in because of like what I thought and how I thought about it. Mm-hmm. And then when that happened, like before we left, like, you know, everything that was said between you and Danville was like stuff I needed to just hear. And after that, though, like, after, you know, because some of the things you said, man, like, they were on point. And the same thing with Danville, like. And then, I mean, I don't know if you remember, but I even stopped you. Like, I never met you. I don't even know you. I barely, like, we didn't even know each other's names. You know, like, we had barely found out we had the same last name. Right. So, you know, like, I knew this was for real. Like, this is different, you know. And, I mean, since then, like, man, it's just been good. Because when I went, like, even though I wasn't supposed to be there, from my point of view, what I remember you saying every time was, even though you don't think you're not supposed to be here, you are supposed to be here because God brought you here. And then when you said, like, oh, even the GPS will bring you here without you knowing, I was just like, well, yeah. But I didn't think of that at the moment, you know, because everything was fresh. And I was like, well, let me see if this is for real or whatever. So as the days went on, and now it's been like a couple weeks since it's happened, it has been for real for me. Like, there's just been no joke. Like, even though I may not have had the vision that some other people had or seen some of the things that other people had, that didn't matter, because I know that even though I may not have had the encounter right then and there, that following week and since then, I've just been like, you know, on my own time with God. Like, I can, like, what had happened to me was I felt like something inside of me was dying and I didn't want it to. My heart, I felt getting colder and colder just because a lot of things had been going on. And my thing, like, even before we even went, me and my son, to the event, you know, we were leaving on a Friday, and on that Friday, I just had an actual breakdown of everything that had been overwhelming me for so long. Mm-hmm. So when I had that, I was just like, God, I just need reassurance, like, that I'm okay, you know, just like a, you know, the way I love my son is the same, you know, the same way I tell my son, like, man, I'm, you know, don't worry, things are okay. You know, I got you. I'm going to be there. We can restart, you know, because for me, it was a business venture that I had tried to do, but it didn't work out the way I was hoping it would take off, you know. So nobody knew that I was carrying that for so long, that the failure of, man, I didn't succeed, I didn't achieve what I wanted to or set out for this. But nobody knew how bad it was really affecting me on the inside. Because on the outside, well, you can play it all off, make it look all good, and that's what I've been doing. But that Friday, I was just finally overwhelmed with everything, just trying to, like, figure out what was going on. So I said, God, just let me know everything's okay. I need to hear something. Not knowing that the event I was about to go to was called The Encounter. So I never knew that. You know, my wife made the shirts and everything, and I still didn't even pay attention to none of it. That's how clueless I was about the whole thing and what was about to happen. So we go and do all that. But like I said, everything that was said that Sunday, I started seeing unfold, like, throughout the days and weeks. Because for me, since I go to work, I drive 30, 45 minutes to work or home from, you know, depending on traffic. And one of the things you guys said was, you know, as I drive, you know, I'm going to be, you know, God is going to be in the car with me, because that's going to be my alone time, you know, because I'm busy, like, nonstop. Sometimes my only rest time would be probably like 7 o'clock at night. That's it. Other than that, I'm going. So for that to be like, let's see what happens, you know. So it was like just throwing some worship music and just see how it goes. Because even then, I wasn't even listening to worship music for a couple months, because it was like, I'm not feeling nothing. I'm just not with it right now. I mean, you know, like, it's like, you know, God exists, and you like, I don't want to ask, but you have to. Like, one of those things where you're like, oh, man, that's how I was feeling. That's how I've been feeling towards God. Like, man, I don't want to, but I have to, because I know you're my dad and I got to do this. You know, that kind of feeling is what I was having before the encounter. So, you know, as I said, you know what, let me see. Let me put on some worship music and just get it in my body. And sure enough, as I'm driving at like 6:30 in the morning to work, I put on some worship music and it just like overtakes the car. Like, the feeling in the car was like, I mean, I was just like, man, there's nobody in the car but me. And then, you know, I tell myself, like, you're not alone in the car. Like, you're not feeling this for no reason. There's somebody right next to you. Like, and since then, it was like, you know what? You know, speak more and, you know, in tongues and stuff like that. So I said, okay. And, you know, this is just things like, you know, do this, do that. And I'm just like, all right, let me try it out. And sure enough, man, since I've been doing that in my car, like, I feel different inside, man. Like, I told her, you know, like, and I had told people there too at the event, like, I was starting to feel like the Grinch, you know, not in the sense of being like uptight or nothing, but more of like the heart part. Like, you know, your heart was big at one time, but now all of a sudden, slowly, it started fading, getting smaller. But after the event, man, it was just like, you know what? I felt a bunch of weight lifted off. I felt like just God said, you know what? I got you. Don't worry about it. Because that's exactly what you guys had said. You know, that God said, don't worry about it. Like, I got you, basically. And that's what I said on Friday. This was on Sunday when this happened. Wow. You know, so everything that was I said on Friday was reassured to me on that Sunday.
Wow.
And like I said, man, it was me going like very like, I don't know about these guys. You know, And I mean, she can tell you too, like even a lot of people I meet, I can tell when somebody's being for real and when somebody's being fake. Like I can, but in this case, it was like, well, let me see. And since the days, man, like I just can't stop. Like I just can't stop talking about the event, man. Like I'm serious.
It's
like,
really life changing.
Like I can't stop talking about it. Like even to the people at work, like it's like I tell them about the event I went to and they're like, for real? I'm like, yeah, man, like you have no idea how I was feeling before it, man. You have no idea what I was going through on the inside. Nobody did. I said, but God did. I said, God knew. And even though I tell myself I wasn't supposed to be there, God knew I was supposed to be there.
Absolutely. I said,
because, like, you know, and I tell everybody, like, I told this guy that works with me that when all the business stuff had went down and I was carrying all the weight, it was like there was no more ambition. There was no more desire. There was like no more dream. There was no more nothing that I was feeling. And after the event, and even until now, because, you know, we're still going, it's like I have something new burning inside.
Come on.
I don't know what it is that the next venture is, or whether it's business. I don't know what it is. Like, I can't put my hand on it. But I know it's something new because, like, I told the guy, he works with me. I told him, dude, I can't describe what it is, but I know there's something there. And I said, I'm happy with that because before any of this happened, I was like, I didn't know what was going to be next for me after this stuff, after this business thing. And after the event, it's just like, you know, God gave me a breath of fresh air.
Come on.
Like, you know, like, you know what? You know, you guys told me, like, God said, you know what? We're going to get up. We're going to restart. We're going to redo something. And it's happening, man, because I don't know what it is, but I know it's restarting something. And, you know, to also, like, you know, let you know and a couple people who watch that this is for real. Like, even since the event and since the year changed, like, work outside of my work has just been busy, too. Like, I I had been praying months to get busy how I had got before, and it didn't happen. And now after this event, like, we're almost about to be done with January, and there has not been a day, man, where I'm not doing something for somebody. Like, I don't know how to explain it, but I know it's God because... So, I know there was, you know, like, God, I knew there was something there.
Yeah. So practically, like, what you're telling me is, like, God really brought you, kind of how we say it, like, from death to life. And he brought your spirit back to life, but then he also brought your business back to life as well.
I mean, I don't know about the business part because... You know, for me, I'm just like, you know, because I think about how months ago I was like, you know what, God, just send me some work. You send me work, I'm going to do it. That's how I'm seeing it. Like, you know, you're bringing me the work. And because I asked for it months ago, well, I have to do it. You know, that's my obligation. You know, if I ask for this, well, now it's up to me to do it. You know, but I felt like there was something blocking it. You know, like, yeah, I was praying. And I was doing what a lot of people do, you know, pray, you go to church, this, that. But I think it was more than that. You know, I think it was like, no, you just need to let it go. Like, mentally, like, just let it go. Whatever it is, because that's what it was for me. I don't, you know, it was just a lot of weight, man, a lot of hurt, a lot of less whatever, but... The thing with that was, too, man, it had nothing to do with people.
Right.
The anger, the frustration, none of that had to do with people. Mm. Everything that I was feeling was towards God himself. That's why I'm saying, like, when you're mad with your dad, you like don't want to ask him something, but you know you have to because he can do it. You know, that's how I was feeling towards him.
So Juan, what would you tell somebody who could be watching right now and is thinking, I know exactly what he's talking about when he says, I don't want to really talk to God, even though I know he's my father, but I'm just really upset because of all the frustration that I've gone through, all the disappointment that I've gone through. And what would you say to someone who just feels like they don't really have that life or that fire or that I guess that passion for God because of the things that happened to them? What would you say to them?
Does somebody like feeling like that? I would say, you know, like, just, I mean, what I did is I just asked no matter what. Like, I just, like, I know for a fact, like, I don't want to, but I have to force myself to do it, you know, because if I also want to benefit and I want to see something, well, I also have to lay down the pride and say, you know what, God, you know how I'm really feeling. Like, because what I did that Friday was I was real with my emotions. Like, I like, a lot of people say God knows everything. Yeah, I know that. Like, we all know God knows everything. And I've heard people say, well, sometimes God wants you to actually tell him. Like, if it's a relationship, well, you're going to tell your partner exactly how you feel, whether they like to hear it or not. You know, the point is to get it off your chest and hopefully things work out and all that. So that's what I did. Like, when I had my breakthrough that Friday was I just said, you know what, God, even though I know you know everything, I'm still going to let you know. Even though I feel this way, I'm going to let you know how I feel. Because if I don't, who else am I going to tell if I don't talk to nobody? You know, and who better to talk to than God himself, who's really going to take everything off of you. It might not be immediately, because I'm not saying that's what happened to me immediately, because it didn't. Mm. You know, but it did take me to a place where I encountered something that it changed inside of me because I was real. And I was like, and I guess that's the thing that was holding in the way. Like, I was finally real with God and he said, yes, that's all I wanted. But let me tell you everything that you just, everything you said to me, let me say it to you so that you can know is what I feel now, you know? So it's just like, just let him know, because he's going to throw it back in your face. But when he throws it at you, it's different. You know, it's different because, you know, it's coming from somebody who truly loves you. It's not just coming from any random person. Like, you're talking to a man, just an all-consuming, awesome God. Like, it's not just anybody.
Well, I want to ask you, and I think this is a great way to close, because I really see that there's the passion and the fire of God that's really burning inside of you, and I'm really excited to see it. I want to ask you to close us out in prayer, but pray for those who are watching, especially those, because there's many people right now who are missing that fire, who are missing that passion, not just for the relationship with God, but just for life in general. Like, they just feel like they're just waking up and just doing their duties, but there's no breath, there's no life to it. So could you close us out and pray for those people?
For the ones struggling, basically?
Absolutely.
Okay. Okay. All right. Well, Heavenly Father, I just really want to take this time and first of all say thank you for this moment that I was able to finally tell Freddie how I felt about the whole event, you know, and it was great, God. But just like it impacted me, I would also like this message that comes through this video to impact the people who watch it. Because I know a lot of people need to hear something like this from people who can relate to their situations, God. And you know what mine was at the moment. And if there are people who can relate, God, just let them break that pride just a little bit to say, God, I need your help. Because you will help, God. Not just that, God, but you will bring them the people that would just yes. love on them and just speak life into them, God, because that's what a lot of people need right now. It's just a breath of fresh air, God. And who better than to come from it from you? So, Lord, I pray for these people. And as you give them this fresh wind, this fresh breath in their everyday life, God, that they would just grow and come to know you, God. And then as you refresh them, let them just see that you have been there all along. It's just we let things get in the way to where we can't see you. So Lord, just drop the guard on the people and just give them this new wind, new air, and let it just be impactful in their lives like it was in mine. And in Jesus' name, I pray for them, Lord. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Awesome. Well, thank you guys so much for watching this video. Again, thank you so much, Juan and Sarah, for being part of this. I'm so excited for what God is going to do. If you are in Houston, stay tuned because we are not done. We're definitely coming back. So I want you to stay tuned for that. But other than that, if you're watching this video and you're enjoying what you're seeing, I want to ask you that you like and that you subscribe and help support this ministry so we can continue to touch more people. We love you guys. Thank you so much. And may God bless you abundantly. Bye-bye.
All right.
All right.